Hey guys, we made it. The elusive grocery store lights of heaven upon you. The moon up your ass. With molasses. Okay, luxury vehicle. A luxury vehicle from space. This is gonna be great. I mean, can you see the awesome shadow of the awesome person in the awesome car? Shut up, fucking dog! An awesome piece of crap canine. It smells like shit out here lately. Sewage. Well, look, the sewage plant's going crazy. Or the farms or something. Shut the fuck up! I help if I, how do you put this? Shut the damn door. I can't believe I can't find an app that doesn't light the light up on the phone when you're video recording, you know? Does that make sense? Maybe I'm the genius who has to become a trillionaire out there. Shut up. All right, it's about $100 worth of groceries. Didn't think it was going to be that much. I'd say about, $60-$70 of it is junk food. Oh, God, this person looking at me and talking to myself in the car. Oh, my God, I'm so embarrassed at the totality of my ShitsVille. Okay, let's go. Whoops. No biggie. Piece of shit car anyways. I'm like a bird. I just want to fucking fly high and shit in somebody's fucking eye high. I just want to die. Then I don't have to fly high. Because that's where I am when I'm high. Yai. I just came up with that. Cut this guy off. Everything's a competition. Boom. Run over the curb. Boosh. Boosh. Flat tire. Fuck. Still driving. I'm one of those people that if I got a flat and I was in a hurry, I'd just haul ass and say, fuck you, rim. Hello? Fag. What the fuck you honking at me for? Dick suck. I hate when people do that. The guy actually honked at me. I wasn't going quick enough for him. Maybe they know me. I doubt it, though. I don't know that many people in this fucking town, and the ones that I do now know now I don't trust. Common theme in this town, I was thinking yesterday, is shit, what is it? You know, I can't recall now. It's a common theme, something having to do with basically people being misleading or not unreliable, what is it? God damn it. Nah, I guess it wasn't that important. Basically, it comes down to people are pretty much untrustworthy. Selfish, that was it. They're selfish. They're self-centered and selfish. Pretending to be caring people, but really, they're looking out for themselves, which probably we all do, and I probably like that too. But to a certain degree, I mean, everybody accepts that because there's no way around that because you're living in your own movie in your own head. But you also have to realize that other people have movies going on with their own drama and feelings. So you have to be nice enough to not hurt their fucking feelings in a complete uncaring, selfish manner. Which is, it's an uncaring selfishness. Let me correct myself. I stand corrected. Indubitably. Therefore, I did this and that. I prefer indubitably instead of allegedly, but hey. Yeah, they're uncaringly self-centered, selfish people that appear to be really great at first, and you start getting little glimpses of their true nature, and then it ends up you're just fucking not friends with them at all. And this has happened not just with a couple girls here, but a few guys too. It's like, oh yeah, well fuck you too. One guy got mad at me one night because he followed me over to these guys' houses that I used to like go over there and hang out with when I was partying, like because they lived a block from the bar. So he follows me over there. I don't know what the hell he's doing here. I didn't know they didn't like this guy. All of a sudden, we're in the kitchen. I was really fucking high on, weed and psych meds that I was taking for a few months, depression and anxiety meds, like three different ones, and drunk as shit. So anyways, we're in the kitchen. I vaguely remember all of a sudden, one guy starts pushing this guy underneath his chin with his forearm. And I hear something about, are you a narc? And then I was like, fuck this. And I was left. But then later, I got pissed off walking down the street. Like 15 minutes later, I was like, "What the fuck? Your friend just beat the shit out of so and so." And I don't even think he beat him up. I think they pushed him around, calling, accusing him, and being a narc. I don't know. Whatever. I don't even know what the fuck happened. So anyway, I'd see that guy around, and he'd just look at me like, "What the fuck, dude?" Which he's probably right. But I was too fucked up to even realize what was going on until it was too late, and I didn't really. I don't know. I should have stood up for the dude. But that's not even what I'm talking about. I'm getting off point here. Because, you know, is there really a point? Maybe there's several points. Maybe it's not even a point. Maybe it's a big fucking sphere that people think trillions and zillions of points are, but all these little points make up a big fucking ball. And it's not even a round ball. It's an introverted ball. We're inside of a... There's that shithole I used to work. 6.75 hours, motherfuckers! Didn't forget it, Sharon! Bitch! Power tripping fucking old saggy cunt. They deducted my paycheck hours saying I worked extra when they're the ones told me to come in the first fucking place early when I first started there. And then they changed the schedule and their thing was, yeah, we changed the schedule. You can't do that anymore. We put a note up. They put these stupid little notes up everywhere instead of actually talking to people. I never even fucking read the notes. Like at every job, I don't care. Every stupid remedial job you have, people are like, ooh, did you hear there's an employee meeting coming up? Ooh. I'm like, no, I didn't. I don't give a fuck. Just leave me alone. You fucking sacks of shit that take these fucking crap jobs seriously. Why don't you take the fact that you're working at a shit job seriously and try to fucking change it? No, we're just happy breeding. Maybe if I was a breeder, I rarely ever get laid. You know, every couple of years I'll have a one-night stand. That's about it the past decade. But maybe if I was happily breeding, then I'd be fine. Just busting a nut once in a while inside of your partner or on your partner instead of your hand. And then I'd be, oh, it doesn't matter. I'll just work a shit fucking job with power trippers for minimum wage. I don't have any goals in life. I don't fucking care about shit. I'm happy as fuck. I'm a simpleton who's happy as fucking shit. That would be great if I could be that happy. But I'm not. Oh, fuck. Here we go. Okay. Let's unload the food. Okay, bye-bye.